Welcome. Here the question says, the LCM of three different numbers is 120. Which of the following cannot be their HCF? And they have given us four options. So they are saying that the LCM of three different numbers is 120. So there are three different numbers, and the lowest common multiple of these three different numbers is 120. And we have to find that out of these four options, which of them cannot be the HCF of those three different numbers. So let us start solving this question. So first we will take option number 1, 8. Can 8 be the HCF of those three different numbers or not? So let us say that 8 can be the HCF of those three different numbers. So we are saying that 8 can be the HCF of those three different numbers. So let us check whether this statement is correct or not. So we will check whether this statement is correct or not. So check this statement. So let us check this statement. Now, if 8 is the HCF of those three different numbers, then those three different numbers can be 8x, 8y and 8z, where x, y and z are coprime numbers. If 8 is the HCF of those three different numbers, then those three different numbers can be 8x, 8y and 8z, where x, y and z are coprime numbers. So let us say this is first number. This is the second number. And this is the third number. So the three numbers are 8x, 8y and 8z, where x, y and z are coprime numbers. So if 8 is the HCF of those three different numbers, then those three different numbers are 8x, 8y and 8z, where x, y and z are coprime numbers. So the three numbers are 8x, 8y and 8z. Now, what is the LCM of 8x, 8y and 8z? So LCM of 8x, 8y and 8z. What is that? So that is 8xyz. The LCM of 8x, 8y and 8z is 8xyz. And now, as per the question, they are saying that the LCM of those three different numbers is 120. So as per the question, the LCM of those three numbers, which are 8x, 8y and 8z, that is 120. So from these two statements, I can say that 8xyz is equal to 120, because as per the calculation, the LCM of those three numbers is 8xyz. But according to the question, the LCM of those three numbers is 120. So therefore, I can say 8xyz is equal to 120. So therefore, I can say that xyz is equal to 120 divided by 8, and 120 divided by 8 is 15. So xyz is equal to 15. Now if XYZ is equal to 15, I can say that X is equal to 1, Y is equal to 3 and Z is equal to 5, because 1 into 3 into 5 is 15. So I can assume that X is equal to 1, Y is equal to 3 and Z is equal to 5, because the product of 1, 3 and 5 is 15. 1 into 3 into 5 is 15. So X is 1, Y is 3, Z is 5. So now our three numbers become, so the first number is equal to 8 into 1, because X is 1. So the first number is 8 into 1, and 8 into 1 is 8. So the first number is 8. The second number is 8 into 3, because the value of Y is 3. So the second number is 8 into 3, and 8 into 3 is 24. So the second number is 24. And the third number is 8 into 5, because Z is equal to 5. So the third number is 8 into 5, and 8 into 5 is 40. So the three numbers are 8, 24 and 40. And when the three numbers are 8, 24 and 40, their HCF is 8 and their LCM is 120. So we have found out that 8 can be the HCF of those three different numbers. Now let us go to option number 2. 12. Whether 12 can be the HCF of those three different numbers or not. So let us say that 12 can be the HCF of those three different numbers. So here we are saying that 12 can be the HCF of those three different numbers. So let us check this statement, whether this statement is correct or not. So let us check this statement. So I am saying that 12 can be the HCF of those three different numbers. So if 12 can be the HCF of those three different numbers, then those three different numbers, I can label them as 12x, 12y and 12z. So those three different numbers are 12x, 12y and 12z. So 12x is the first number, first number. 12y is the second number and 12z is the third number, and x, y, z are co-prime numbers. So 12 is the HCF of those three different numbers. And if 12 is the HCF of those three different numbers, then those three different numbers are 12x, 12y and 12z, where x, y and z are co-prime numbers. So the first number is 12x, the second number is 12y and the third number is 12z, and x, y, z are co-prime numbers. So what is the LCM of 12x, 12y and 12z? What is the LCM of these three different numbers? So LCM of 12x, 12y and 12z, that is equal to 12xyz. The LCM of 12x, 12y and 12z is 12xyz. Now, as per the question, the LCM of those three different numbers is 120. So the LCM of those three different numbers is 120. So LCM of 12x, 12y and 12z is 120. So as per the question, the LCM of 12x, 12y and 12z is 120. So as per the calculation, the LCM of these three different numbers is 12xyz. But as per the question, the LCM of these three numbers is 120. So from these two statements, I can say that 12xyz is equal to 120. So 12xyz, this is equal to 120. So I can say that xyz is equal to 120 divided by 12, and 120 divided by 12 is 10. So xyz is equal to 10. So from here I can say that x is equal to 1, y is equal to 2 and z is equal to 5. xyz is equal to 10. So from here I can say that x is equal to 1, y is equal to 2 and z is equal to 5. So 1 into 2 into 5 is 10. So I can take the values of x, y and z as 1, 2 and 5 respectively. So now the three numbers, what are they? So the first number will be 12 into 1 because the value of x is 1. So the first number becomes 12 into 1 and 12 into 1 is 12. The second number becomes 12 into 2 because the value of y is 2. So 12 into 2 and 12 into 2 is 24. And the third number becomes 12 into 5 because the value of z is 5. So the third number becomes 12 into 5 and 12 into 5 is 60. So the three different numbers are 12, 24 and 60. And the HCF of 12, 24 and 60 is 12. And the LCM of 12, 24 and 60 is 120. So we have found out that 12 can be the HCF of those three different numbers. Now the third option is 24. So we will say that 24 can be the HCF of those three different numbers. So 24 can be the HCF of those three different numbers. So I am saying that 24 can be the HCF of those three different numbers. So let us check this statement. We will have to check whether this statement is correct or not. Now, if 24 is the HCF of those three different numbers, then those three different numbers can be 24x, 24y and 24z. So 24x is the first number, 24y is the second number, and 24z is the third number, and x, y and z are coprime numbers. X, y and z are coprime numbers. So I have assumed that 24 is the highest common factor of those three different numbers. And if 24 is the HCF of those three different numbers, then I can say that the three different numbers are 24x, 24y and 24z, where x, y and z are coprime numbers. Now, what is the LCM of these three different numbers? So LCM of 24x, 24y, this is x, okay, 24x, 24y and 24z. So what is the LCM of these three different numbers? It is 24xyz. Now, as per the question, the LCM of the three different numbers is 120. So the LCM of these three different numbers is 120. So LCM of 24x, 24y and 24z, that is 120. So as per the calculation, the LCM of these three numbers is 24xyz, and as per the question, the LCM of these three different numbers is 120. So from these two statements, I can say that 24xyz is equal to 120. So I can say that 24xyz is equal to 120. So therefore, I can say that xyz is equal to 120 by 24, and 120 divided by 24 is 5. So xyz is equal to 5. Now xyz is equal to 5. So x is equal to 1, y is equal to 1, and z is equal to 5. Xyz is equal to 5. So I can take the value of x, y, and z as 1, 1, and 5 respectively, because 5, if you do the prime factorization, it is 1 into 5, or 5 can be written as 1 into 5. So it is 1, 1, and 5. 1 into 1 into 5 is 5. So x is 1, y is 1, z is 5. So now the three numbers will be what? The first number will be 24 into 1, because the value of x is 1. So the first number will become 24 into 1. And 24 into 1 is 24. The second number will become 24 into 1. So 24 into 1 is 24, because y is also equal to 1. So it will become 24. 24 into 1 is 24. So from here only, you can see that both the numbers are same numbers. They are not different numbers, because the value of x and y are same. Both are 1. So both of them has become 24 into 1, and 24 into 1 is 24. So both the numbers are same numbers. Whereas in the question, they are saying that there should be three different numbers. So therefore, from here I can say that 24 cannot be the HCF of those three different numbers. Because if 24 is the HCF of those three different numbers, those three different numbers are not different. Out of the three numbers, two numbers will be the same. Whereas in the question, they are saying that all the three numbers should be different. So therefore, 24 cannot be the HCF of those three different numbers. Because if 24 is the HCF of those three different numbers, the numbers are not different. The first number and the second number are the same. Even though the third number will be different, but the first two numbers are same. So therefore, 24 cannot be the HCF of these three different numbers. So our assumption is false. Our assumption that 24 can be the HCF of those three different numbers is false. Now let us go to option number 4. And this option, I will do it a bit fast, because already this video is 18 minutes long. So option number 4 is 35. So let us say that 35 is the HCF of those three different numbers. So let us say 35 can be the HCF of those three different numbers. So if, and we have to check this statement. Okay. So we are saying that 35 can be the HCF of those three different numbers. So we are checking this statement, whether it is true or false. Now, if 35 is the HCF of those three different numbers, the three different numbers are 35x, 35y, and 35z. where x, y and z are coprime numbers. X, y, z are coprime numbers. So this is the first number. This is the second number. And this is the third number. So if 35 is the HCF of those three different numbers, I can say that the first number, second number and third number is 35x, 35y and 35z, where x, y and z are coprime numbers. So what is the HCF of, what is the LCM of these three different numbers? What is the LCM of 35x, 35y and 35z? The LCM of these three different numbers is 35xyz. If you calculate the, LCM. What is the LCM of these three different numbers? The LCM of these three different numbers is 35xyz. The lowest common multiple of 35x, 35y and 35z is 35xyz. And as per the question, the LCM of these three different numbers is 120. So the LCM of 35x, 35y and 35z is 120. So I can write that 35xyz is equal to 120. Because when you calculate the LCM of these three different numbers, it comes out to be 35xyz. And as per the question, the LCM of these three different numbers is 120. So I can say that 35xyz is equal to 120. Now, xyz. So xyz will be equal to 120 divided by 35. And 120 divided by 35 doesn't give you an integer value. 120 divided by 35, this doesn't give you an integer value. So 120 is not divisible by 35. 120 is not divisible by 35. So therefore, xyz is not an integer value. So this is wrong. So our assumption that 35 can be the HCF of those three different numbers is wrong, because 120 is not divisible by 35. So our assumption that 35 can be the HCF of those three different numbers is wrong. So out of the four options, the first two options are correct. So 8 and 12 can be the HCF of those three different numbers whose LCM is 120, whereas 24 and 35 cannot be the HCF of those three different numbers whose LCM is 120. So which of the following cannot be their HCF? Option number 3 and option number 4. These are the two correct answers for this question. And with that, I am closing this video.